Thanks, Lily, and thanks to the Vasari group for hosting this panel. I think it's a really important discussion and super relevant to how I think designers are are sort of grappling with the idea of interoperability in practice. Lily, you mentioned a couple of my plugins via the proving ground. What I'm actually going to be talking about today is an add-in that we're developing at Case, which is our hope is to help facilitate the interoperability between, I think, more broadly Rhino, and certainly Grasshopper is a part of this, and the environments of Revit and Vasari. So this is actually what we're calling an OpenNURBS importer, and I'm sure we can come up with a zippier name as we move this forward. But I think the there's an interesting conceptual challenge here when we begin to discuss the interoperability between Grasshopper and Revit and Vasari. Grasshopper, of course, is a visual language that is built on top of Rhino as a plugin, which is interesting in that Grasshopper really isn't its own sort of platform environment. It really is built on the .NET framework. It's heavily linked to the Rhino SDK, whereas Revit and Vasari is its own sort of full blown BIM platform. So kind of getting to the heart of the matter, we kind of took the approach of, well, let's look at Rhino and the representations available to us in the Rhino file format, and we can support Grasshopper via the OpenNURBS 3DM format. So our kind of goals in this sort of exploration were to establish a way for Vasari and Revit to read the Rhino 3DM file format directly, so you're not kind of going through an external file format or setting up sort of an intermediary. We were interested in creating this possibility of when you're in Revit, you can just one click find a Rhino file and kind of open and bring the geometry in for a certain purpose. So we focused on, I think, methods for geometry translation first and foremost. We wanted to get a handle on the differences between how geometry is represented in the Rhino file format and how it can be represented accurately in the Revit and Vasari conceptual massing environment. And the tool is ultimately, we see it as sort of a way to support conceptual form making. So if you're kind of loosely modeling in the Rhino environment or generating Grasshopper geometry, the intent is to use this, the OpenNURBS importer, to be able to bring in that geometry into sort of the Vasari conceptual massing environment and then kind of continue your development in that environment. So we wanted to kind of make that sort of translation as sort of seamless as possible. And of course that comes with a number of challenges. Rhino being kind of a NURBS-based modeler, has sort of a representation, a geometry representation schema that is in many ways very different than the geometry representations that you see in the the Vasari conceptual massing environment, the Revit conceptual massing environment, etc. So a lot of the development effort on this tool has been to kind of create sort of bridges and processes which we can used to accurately bridge these two environments and ensure sort of an accurate geometry representation or sort of approximation across the two platforms. You may have seen a couple of posts on my blog, The Proving Ground, on this. Obviously, both Rhino and Revit support NURBS, and they both support the mathematical model of NURBS correctly, but there are slight variations in sort of the implementation of NURBS that can create a couple of hiccups down the line. And so this diagram really kind of just shows that while both in programs and environments are implementing NURBS, in this case just on the level of a spline, because knot vectors are computed slightly differently or implemented slightly differently, you get sort of a deviation. Both curves are correct, and both curves are sort of accurate within their own worlds, but when you kind of combine them together, you can kind of see that there are sort of little discrepancies. Likewise with, spline interpolation, you can kind of quickly see that, the way, Revit interpolates a spline curve, it's using a very different computation, a very different algorithm than how Rhino might interpolate a spline curve. So we needed to kind of develop techniques and methods that would allow the user to begin to, iterate on that curve and construct an accurate spline representation across the surface, so you don't get sort of unexpected deviations between the two programs. And the same goes with surfaces. So, as you're kind of modeling surfaces, we start to encounter that, a loft surface is not the same loft surface as it might exist in the Rhino environment. So similar sort of iterative method there to kind of help move the surfaces closer together in terms of their deviation. You kind of see some of those techniques at work here, going from a max deviation of sort of 1.1 units to 0.005 units in tolerance. So these are sort of methodologies that sort of are built in under the hood of what eventually just becomes a very simple interface that can be loaded through Revit and Vasari. So when you're in the conceptual masking environment, these are all the types of curves and surface geometries that we're sort of supporting. So it's just a matter of finding that Rhino file. There are, of course, some things that can't be represented quite yet. So we're just sort of bringing awareness to sort of what can be represented through this panel. And similarly, if you go into a project and family environment, a lot of these this functionality kind of goes away when you're sort of in Revit. We've kind of made this menu sort of adaptive to a particular environment to kind of very clearly show the user what is going to be brought in and also give user and control over precisely what they want to bring in. And so this is a couple of shots of sort of the plugin or the add-in in action. Most of the development is on the Revit side on this, just sort of building an add-in which can read that 3DM file directly. So you kind of see the representation on the Rhino world and eventually what Revit and Vasari reads in via conceptual massing. One of the things that I think is really interesting about this workflow is that, everything that you can bring in through this add-in, could theoretically be modeled by hand in Vasari. While it could be theoretically modeled by hand, it can become very, very difficult. So this is actually a Grasshopper generated model. And so what the add-in takes care of is sort of the construction of all the construction planes, the development and placement of every single face. So you're kind of getting that translation across. And the same with sort of more complex forms. So I actually posted this on Twitter, I think, a couple of weeks ago, which is sort of a couple of subdivision surfaces that have been converted to NURBS and Rhino and were then translated through the case add-in to the Vasari / conceptual massing environment in Rhino. So you can kind of see that there's sort of an integrity of the surface happening. There's the cotangent surfaces being developed and placed here sort of automatically. So current development schedule is that we're hoping to kind of release a beta for Vasari in October for the OpenNURBS importer. So you guys will be kind of welcome to sort of try it out for a period, and we're kind of continuing kind of the development of a pro version for Revit, which there's not a sort of set deadline on that yet, but we're kind of getting close. So I just wanted to quickly jump over into Revit and just kind of show how this sort of plays out. So I just clicked on, this is actually the conceptual massing environment, so it pretty much in my mind exists in the same world as Vasari, to where you've got your add-ins, you've got everything that Vasari supports for conceptual massing support in the Revit conceptual massing environment here. So I'm just going to load a file. So I'm just clicking on the file path. I'm looking for a Rhino 3DM file. And I'll kind of just click on this guy. This is just sort of a file that contains a bunch of curves. It'll bring those in, and so when I kind of zoom in here, you can kind of see that this is actually now a NURB, the equivalent of the Revit NURBS representation, of course, taking into account the variances in how knots are computed, so you're getting a completely accurate translation of those curves. And I'll do one more. I'll do this guy. And yeah, this is sort of a B-rep, that was represented in Rhino, so sort of a solid element. You'll notice that, currently there's no way to, via the API to sort of join surfaces into solids. So these are kind of being brought in as sort of planar faces. So it has to break apart the B-rep and kind of model it face by face. Currently there's no methods available to sort of join these together into what would be a true solid. So that's one of the current limitations. As the API develops, as this tool develops, that will hopefully get resolved down the line. And I'll just sort of do one more. And this is a file that just has sort of a single surface. So if you're kind of modeling and manipulating different surfaces in the Rhino environment, and you want those to be brought in for further development, say you want to divide that surface now using the inbuilt Revit functionality, it allows you to kind of bridge that gap, adding more detail, manipulating things, and changing things up. So that's it for me. If there are any questions? I should note that while I'm kind of picking out the geometric differences, I don't necessarily consider one to be more correct than the other. It's just sort of a matter of implementation, and part of the sort of job of this tool is to kind of begin to navigate those and begin to understand those issues correctly, so we can kind of build tools that allow us to work better. So I remain kind of neutral on that subject.